Hey, it's Tim, and today we're at Mickey's Not-So-Scary Halloween Party! So I can't believe today is finally here. When we booked our holiday all those months ago and we found out that the first day of Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party was whilst we're on vacation, we couldn't believe our luck. So immediately as the tickets went on sale, we purchased one. We've always wanted to come to a Disney Halloween event and today is the day. So there's a couple of key things that we want to do and see today. First of all, of course, there's our special Halloween parade, the Boo to You, Mickey's Boo to You parade. Really excited about that, excited to see, well, which characters are going to be involved, the special floats, and of course about 10 or 15 minutes before the parade starts, we get to see that headless horseman. I think that'll be something really special. We've also got the fireworks show, which is a special one for tonight, so that's the Not So Spooky Fireworks Spectacular. That's on at about 10:15, so that should be really, really cool. Really looking forward to that, especially the special projection mappings that they have for this Halloween event on the castle. And last but not least, we've got the Hocus Pocus Villain Spectacular, which is a special stage show. They're doing three shows tonight outside the castle, and fingers crossed we're going to catch that at least once. Other than that, well, there's loads to do. Loads of special character meet and greets, so let's see how many of those we can rack up. But priority number one, of course, is meeting Jack Skellington and Sally. But also, there's all those trick and treat stations across the park. So they've given us special little bags, and so we intend to fill those to the brim. So all in all, just looking forward to a really special evening at the Magic Kingdom, something that we've never experienced before. Special ticketed event, and yeah, over the moon to be here. First things first, time to get our wristbands.
Enjoy.
Hey.
Hello.
Very excited.
Yes, enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey. Amazing, thank you. And is the map inside?
Yes, it is.
And Kitty's already inside.
Thank you. So first things first, now we've got those special wristbands, we're off to meet Jack and Sally at the Town Hall. I told you it was going to be popular. The queue is absolutely massive. Getting excited now, this is cool. It's been about 45 minutes, so not too bad. And I think we definitely time this right doing it now.
Happy Halloween, everyone! Do join us, please!
I'm liking all the creations you've made. I'm
nice
and strong. I've
compressed
the occasion.
Did you create these yourself?
I wish I did. I think they grow from my head.
They grow from her. You grow these wands every year?
Every year.
You shed them?
Yes.
When you're done with them, can we have them?
Why, they would make for the best decorations. I would stay right here, hoping out.
That was so cool, wasn't it? They were brilliant. Like, what amazing character actors. What a way to start today. The Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party. So here they've got some special statues for the occasion. We spent the past couple of weeks looking for these. And now we've got some Halloween ones. Musketeer Pluto. And Princess Minnie. This is Jester Goofy. Trick or treat bag.
Hello, friends.
Hello, thank you very much.
There you are, my friend.
Thank you.
Yes.
So I've been making friends in Starbucks, and it was 100% worth me wearing this Haunted Mansion shirt, because I've just been chatting to a cast member called David, and David is hosting a TV crew that are here tonight to sort of document and film some of the stuff that's going on for this special Halloween event. So I was picking his brains a bit, so he's given me a belting spot to stand at to wait for the Headless Horseman, and that's apparently a real special occasion tonight, because it's the first time he's coming out since COVID, so it'll been a couple of years. It'll been a couple of years that people haven't seen him, so that's really, really special. So he's told me where to stand for that, to get a good view of him, and also a good view of the parade, Main Street, and all the things that will be happening on Main Street, which we'll see soon, and then of course the castle in the background. So that's been super useful. But also he's given me a real good vantage spot for the fireworks. So he's told us, if possible, we want to stand near the fountain just to the right of the castle. He said that's where you'll get the best view of all the projection mapping on the castle. And also tonight they're doing something that they call perimeter fireworks. I have no idea what that means, but it sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? So David, if you ever watch this in the future, thank you for your help. So this is the special map that we have been given for this special event. Doesn't it look cool? It feels like we've got a top secret map to the Magic Kingdom. So when we open it up, there's a couple of key things in there. First of all, down here, here's all the sort of special food and drink options that are available to us for this event. Particularly like the look of those zombie fingers. And I think Steph's intention is to hunt those down. And the other key section is this entertainment section. And those are those three key entertainment sort of special things that are going on tonight that we absolutely have to see. We have to see the Hocus Pocus show outside the castle. We absolutely are here to see Mickey's Boo to You Halloween parade. I'm very, very excited to see what characters play a part in that. And then, of course, those magical fireworks with unique projection mapping at 10:15. And then if we open it up further, you can see it resembles sort of a typical Magic Kingdom map. But what they've done is they've itemised all the special character meet and greets, which are shown there by those bat symbols, and then also these orange pumpkins are the trick-or-treat stations. Doesn't it look cool? I absolutely love it. We're going to try and get a few copies of these to keep, because I love collecting things like this. Cool, eh? So we're now in a line to meet the Seven Dwarves. You don't normally get the opportunity to do that. How cool! It was great fun, wasn't it? Got to meet all seven dwarves, and I told Dopey he was my favourite. I think we're going to go and find a quick snack. We've not really eaten today, and then it's all about getting our prime spot ready for the parade. So this is our first snack of the event. It's a Mickey Halloween cinnamon roll. Looks good, doesn't it? Top marks. It's actually really, really nice. I was quite surprised. It looked a bit intense with all that orange stuff on top. But it's really nice, so good first treat of the day. Right, I'm gonna hunt down this official event merch. So here's the official event merchandise. With this super cool Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party jumper. How much is that? Oh, it doesn't say. It is glow in the dark though. Cool, eh? Also got that. The date on. I like that. And then of course the Hocus Pocus ears. Got a Mickey Magic Kingdom tea. It's nice, isn't it? Right, so here's what I've been looking for, the Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party mug. Oh, isn't that cool? And then on the other side, picture of the castle. Oh, I really like that. I think we'll buy that. Also got these really nice large tumblers. They're really smart, very good quality as well. Really like that. A limited edition pin. Buying the mug, but I'm also buying this, which is a cool little Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party Christmas decoration. We have a Disney tree at home, full of Disney decorations, and I thought that's a nice little memento that we've been here today. We have made purchases. Right, now to find Steph. Right, we've got our little parade spot. We always sit here, and it was the advice of that guy I spoke to before that this is the place to sit. So we trust him, because we've got a view of the whole of Main Street and the castle in the background. So yeah, we just gotta sit it out. Like, we want a good view. We wanna be at the front, so this is what you gotta do. I tell you what, it's really weird being on Main Street with this type of music playing. It's proper party dance music. It's great, and it completely changes the atmosphere. And I tell you what as well, is this is the only event of the year where you're allowed to dress up. Now we've done a token dress up. I've got my Haunted Mansion shirt on, and Steph's got a Maleficent ears with a Disney Halloween t-shirt on. But some people are properly, like, full on dressed up, properly impressive costumes, and it's really cool. And actually we've seen a couple of the cast members, and even like a cast member press team, collar some of the guests to get pictures with them because their costumes are that good. We also saw a really cute little lad, he was only this big, who dressed up as a cast member, so he had his little badge and everything, and he's just adorable. So we're loving the atmosphere. Totally different for us, this. We've never experienced this before. Really, really unique. Yeah, love it. Already want to come back. Already could want to come back. I've just shown Steph that Christmas tree decoration that I got, and she's happy with that, and I think it'll be nice to have that on the tree this Christmas as a bit of a nod back to what we did this summer. But yeah, absolutely loving it. A long evening ahead of us, some amazing things to experience, but loving it so far. We're starting to come alive now, Main Street now, the lights fading with all these projections that they've got on the buildings. Doesn't it look fantastic? super effective, but to be honest, a haunted mansion float, I never thought I'd see the day. I am a massive haunted mansion fan, obviously got my haunted mansion shirt on tonight. I thought it was wonderful. I love the soundtrack, I love the feel of it, it was really jolly, just brilliant, and great that we've now seen that, as well as the other normal parade on this trip to Orlando. Absolutely brilliant. Now got two key events ahead of us, the fireworks and then the Hocus Pocus Villain Spectacular. And this is our view.
The story that you are about to be told is one for both the young and the old. Unlike anything you've ever seen. Get ready, for this is Halloween.
Friends, it's wonderful to have you here. For I, Jack Skellington, have a tale to tell. Yes, Halloween is a night filled with surprises. Playful tricks, frightful treats. Why, anything can happen on Halloween.
After the fireworks, we ran to Frontierland in the hope to catch the cadaver dance, but we only caught the last 10 seconds. Boo, which is a real shame, but the crowds getting out of that central hub were so, so heavy. However, with the power of editing, I can transport you back to Magic Kingdom from earlier today when we were in the park before Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party started, when we bumped into the Dapper Dans, who remarkably look and sound very similar, and we got to hear them do a rendition of Grim Grinning Ghosts.
When the crypt door creaks and the tombstones quake, spooks come out for swing and wake. Happy aunts materialize and begin to vocalize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize. Don't close your eyes, don't try to hide or silly spook.
Boo!
is by your side. Shrouded in a death disguise, they pretend to terrorize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
Socialize.
When you hear the knell of a requiem bell, weird glows gleam where spirits dwell. Restless bones, ethereal eyes, rise and spooks of every size. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize. Socialize. As the moon climbs high o'er the dead oak tree, spooks arrive for the midnight spree. Creepy creeps with eerie eyes start to shriek and harmonize. Grim grinning ghosts come out to socialize.
It's trick or treat time. Treats.
Woo!
A few sweets in there. We need to get more. Wow, wow, wow. Wait until you see the Haunted Mansion. Doesn't that look absolutely incredible? That is absolutely amazing, isn't it? Look at that. Just sneaked in the exit just to get a better look. Wow, look at that. We've not got time to ride this tonight, unfortunately. I think that looks absolutely stunning.
Woohoo!
More treats! We tried to get some extra ones then. We're doing particularly badly, but we're marching our way around the park as quickly as possible.
Look!
That's no good.
I guess you have
to. Thank you.
You're welcome.
What we're learning is some of the distributors of candy and sweets are generous. Some are not. So that girl in there, incredible, like, she might as well shoveled it in. Let's see what they like in this one. Time to play the trick-or-treat odds. Who's generous and who's not? Ooh, they've opted to go this way. Are they gonna be generous? Are they not? Let's see. She's hardly got any.
I have got some. Thank you. Trick-or-treat.
Happy Halloween.
Yeah, you've got way more in your bag.
Have a great night.
Thank you.
You're very well.
We turn right. Now we're gonna go back in and turn left. It's time to turn left. Stingy, really stingy in that one. Not good. More treats at Gaston's.
There's people who are more generous than others.
Right. Gaston's is the place to go. She was massively generous. Best one yet. Best one yet. Let's see if we can beat that. Steph just remarked that one. She used two hands to steady the amount of sweets she had. Brilliant. Yeah, Gaston's in firm pole position.
Happy Halloween.
Right,
we're having a competition. Are you as generous as Gaston's?
Yes. There you go. See, that's how they get you.
That. Look at that.
You make it a competition and then we can all
game. Awesome. Happy Halloween, guys.
I should have said that.
Happy Halloween. Tried to make it into a bit of a game. Still not generous, though. Gaston's, like, up there. Right, next one. Cool ride overlay of the teacups there while we're on the hunt for more treats. That was luck, wasn't it? So it's the second parade and we just caught the headless horseman again. So that was cool. So we're gonna carry on trick-or-treating for another 10 minutes or so, but then it's really all about getting that great spot for the Hocus Pocus Villain Spectacular. Back into Tomorrowland for another treat location. Really good, actually, a real great way of doing it. These massive inflatable things are really visible, even if you're quite far away. Just brilliant, not just for kids. Happy for adults to get involved, as we are doing. And this is the next treat location. Thanks, Mike. Hello.
Hi.
Trick or treat!
Halloween.
Now, just so you know, Gaston's are currently winning as the most generous venue. So it's up to you. It's up. Look at that! Laugh floor! Pole position! Pole position!
Woo! He's officially full!
Oh, we love you guys! Thank you! Happy Halloween! Decanting everything into this bag. Steph, on a scale of 1 to absolutely weighs a ton. Oh, they delivered in spades, didn't they? Spades of chocolate. I don't think we're ever going to beat that. Weren't they brilliant sports? Fantastic.
Friends on the other side.
He's got friends on the other side.
Sister, you're something. You put me in a spin. You are uncomprehending. The position that you're in, it's hopeless. You're finished. You haven't got a plan. Cause I'm Mr. Boogie Boogie. And you ain't going nowhere.
By power and right, bring poison apples and give us a fright. From the underworld's ungodly domain, we call for the ruler of death and disdain. Come and inspire with devious plots. And compel here a slithering snake with a sorcerer's power to give but not take.
wasn't that absolutely brilliant? What a way to end a phenomenal day. So there we are, our first time at a Disney Halloween event, and wasn't that just brilliant? It's now 1 a.m. and from 4 p.m. until 12:30, literally we were on the go for every single second. We didn't miss an opportunity to get something done, and I think we both were acutely aware immediately after picking up that special Halloween map at only a couple of seconds after 4 o'clock that flipping heck, there's a lot to get through. And actually I think, being honest with ourselves, what we should have done is we should have booked for two nights. It'd have taken a bit of the stress out of it, and that's probably the only way that you'd see absolutely everything. But for us, it was all about priorities, and those three big entertainment pieces were definitely up there: the fireworks, the parade, and then that Hocus Pocus show. I particularly love the parade. For me, or you can hear the tram come past now, for me an opportunity to see a haunted mansion parade float, I never thought that'd happen. I didn't know they even had one. So I love that. And I thought the fireworks were great, and I was particularly impressed on how they used a real life Jack Skellington character actor to come out on that stage area in front of the projections on the castle. I thought that was really, really cool. And again, I've not seen that before in a fireworks display. So I love that. And the Hocus Pocus show, they did three shows tonight. Just wait for that to pass. A bit noisy, aren't they? And that Hocus Pocus show, which we saw at the end, the way they integrated all those villains from all those different Disney films, I thought was brilliant. To see Jafar and Hades on the same stage, I thought was really cool. I think the way we planned our day worked. So we got our wristbands, we were in Tomorrowland because we knew at 4 o'clock they were issuing wristbands to those that were already in the park that day. So we were in that queue for 3:30, we got the wristbands straight away, and we thought, well, what is going to cause a massive queue? Where's there going to be lots of interest? And we were right, and that was the opportunity to meet Jack and Sally. So we did that straight away, and when we checked the Disney My Disney Experience app later that day, that queue had gone up to 3 hours, which is absolutely outrageous. And honestly, would you want to wait 3 hours in there to meet Jack and Sally? Probably not. So I'm so glad we did that first. Other highlights from earlier in the day, which I did put in the cut in the end, was seeing the Dapper Dans, who then we saw briefly later that night as well. Getting to see them sing Grim Grinning Ghosts was really, really cool, because I absolutely love anything that's Haunted Mansion related. And then our run round the park at the end to do our trick-or-treating. We tried to have some fun with the cast members, and I tell you what, that gang of them in the Monsters Inc. Laugh Floor one, who just gave us bucket loads, were brilliant and such great sports. So yeah, it's been an absolutely fantastic day. I'm now trying to find the car. I think it's over here somewhere. But yeah, absolutely, we're going to be back. We definitely want to do another Halloween event. It was run brilliantly, and the way that they lit up Main Street with the projections towards the castle, all those pumpkins lighting up as it got darker, just brilliant. Loved every second. And so, as always, thanks again for watching. We really appreciate it, and we'll be back at another park soon.